Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. One team comes in off a victory, the other comes in off a defeat. With that, let's get up to Everbank Field in Jacksonville. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Well, Larry, with a sight of fans splashing in pools behind the end zone, we can only be in one place. That's Everbank Field in Jacksonville, Florida. Today, we've got a Week 13 matchup for you here between the Denver Broncos and the Jacksonville Jaguars. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Pinching together, must be expecting the run. That'll carry. It's C.J. Anderson. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. The offensive lineup now, and the guy we highlight, Emmanuel Sanders.
You can use him in any spot as a wide receiver. In the slot, out wide. It doesn't matter. He just makes plays.
I think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19.
Now Paxton Lynch on Lynch fighting. He fumbles. He lost the football.
A play like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, the teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Taken right around the 44. A good return there for 13 yards. And the Jags will have great field position to start this drive as they take over on the short side of the field.
Make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage. When you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
Second down, they need less than a yard to pick up the first.
Here we go now.
Bortles to throw on second down. Over the middle, the connection to Hearns. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. We heard them talk before the game about utilizing the intermediate passing game this week. It works for them there. They move the chains.
And we saw them work on it in practice as well. And most teams take a period at a time to work on different things. They put a couple of periods of work into the intermediate passing game. And now we know exactly why. They got the look that they were seeking, and they were able to take advantage of it.
Here we go. Green, 90.
Bortles now on first down. That is caught. And he's brought down. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. He's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
Now look at the starting unit, and here's to you, Mr. Robinson.
Oh, I like that one. Allen Robinson, I love coming out of Penn State. Everyone kept telling me he's not fast enough.
And I kept pointing to the film and saying yes, but he catches everything.
He's definitely a threat.
They'll try to punch it in with Yeldon. And I think they stopped him again. They did at the one-yard line. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. And here are the defensive starters, and their coordinator is hoping that they have short-term memories from last week.
A very tough week indeed, Brandon. All they want to do now is be solid right out of the gate. No big plays given up early.
Stonewalled on second down. Let's see what they can do on third and goal from the two.
Here we go now. Green, 90.
They'll try and run. This is Robinson. And he'll take this into the end zone. A touchdown, Jacksonville. Denard Robinson with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Jags have taken the early lead. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. The touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And Denver getting set to take the field. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. 3 and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Now let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit better.
Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
All right, here we go. Blue 90! Blue 90!
They'll throw on first down with Lynch. And Green with a catch left side. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
They'll come out in the pistol.
All right, here we go. Blue, land it!
Now Lynch on first down. Screen play, Anderson. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that'll make it second down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Again, we'll see the pistol here.
Here we go now. Blue 90. Blue 90.
Lynch looking to throw on second. Over the middle this time to Fowler. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Set, 3-19. No.
Check it out.
3-19. 3-19.
They go play action here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. And time to take a look at the Jaguar defense.
Dante Fowler missed his rookie season due to injury. So good to have him back on the field. A terrific combination of speed and strength.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Another pistol look here.
Set! Move! Land it!
Second and 10 now. It's Lynch. He's going to let this one go deep. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Ten yards to go on third. Thomas, the lone receiver left.
Here we go. Green, 39. Green.
On third down, Lynch. And down he goes. The pressure getting to Lynch. It's a loss of 10 on the sack, and it leads to fourth. Here's Riley Dixon now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. This is taken around the 12. Call that a 46-yard punt with a net of 40 on the 6-yard return. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around.
Ready! Green! Z! Here we go! Blue 45!
They'll start out on the ground. It's T.J. Yeldon. And he goes across the 20 to the 22. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Second down to the offense needing 5 yards.
Here we go now. Blue 45.
They'll run it again with Yeldon. And he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves his sticks.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary.
Right, 58,
but to a really nice game.
Blue 45, blue 45.
On first and 10, here's Bortles. And incomplete on the deep ball. Marquise Lee, the intended target. That'll bring up second down. Again here on second and 10. Middle of the field, it's Robinson. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. Give him 8 on the play, and that's going to bring up a third down.
Didn't they tell us in our meetings that they needed to account for him on each and every play?
You think? A guy of his caliber? So how does a guy like him get that wide open?
That usually means there's a tire breakdown on what the coverage was. Everyone thought they were doing something, and they were supposed to be doing something else. But bottom line is, no matter what, you have to know where he is and cover him on every play.
Here we go now. Green, 90.
Bortles looking to throw on third and 2. And a dump off here to Robinson. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and it'll be fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And now the Broncos offense, they get set to head back onto the field. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways.
Up,
now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, it's time for them to give them a rest. Took the words right out of my mouth. Green with a catch left side. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and it'll be a second down.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
In the backfield is Anderson.
Green, 39. No, check.
He's going to get the football. And he's able to get up here to the 26. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, 2nd and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. A lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Thomas, the lone receiver, left.
Here we go now.
First and 10, it's Lynch. Over the middle this time to Fowler. And he's brought down after a good game. That one goes for 24 yards. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker. One thing that I observed when Dante Fowler was coming out in the NFL draft, how hard he played the game. Every time I turned on a tape, he was either rushing the passer or making a play in space against a ball downfield, or hustling from one sideline to the other. How about that play right there? Making a nice tackle, holding it to a short gain.
On 2nd down, here's Lynch. And this is incomplete. Back alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's Bronco football to begin quarter number 2. They're on the march, but facing a 3rd down here. And the offense looking to pick up the 1st down after the 2nd down incompletion. And the Jags, Charles, I think they're in the dime here.
Covering a lot of field.
From the gun on 3rd down, it's Lynch. The complete into the hands of Fowler. And he'll get nothing out of that one. Call it a 1-yard gain on the play. And that's going to make it 4th down.
They didn't get the 1st down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. And this one hits at the 1, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. And now out come the Jags. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with a game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Taken down here at about the 23-yard line. Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player. Sometimes you're just rounding it. Sometimes there's a fake, sometimes there's not. That makes it very, very difficult for a DB to stay with it.
So the offense has it first and 10.
Ready, green.
Bortles now on first down. It's caught on the right side by Robinson.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive. Derek Punter, yeah, he wasn't his fault. But listen, there's some casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
7 yards on the play, and it'll make it second down. And now they face a second down. Thomas, the lone receiver, left.
Here we go.
On second down, Lynch. On the right side, caught by Green. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes. So many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
So here we go, first and 10 now. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of 6, and it will set him back for second down.
Dante Fowler just made a play that he could be really proud of there. Nice tackle for loss. And what a relief it is for him to be back on an NFL field after missing his entire rookie season with a knee injury.
I think the entire defensive unit is relieved that he's out there. In the backfield is Anderson.
Here we go. Green 39.
And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Adversity like this.
Lessons. All the time you're going to face these lessons. The key for this guy is will he be able to bounce back in the next one, because right now this has not been his game.
And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way, because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
On first and 10, here's Bortles. Lee's got it over the middle. And down he'll go at the 25. 5 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position, because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Second five.
Double tight, double tight.
Yeah, the low running back. After a gain of five, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on third down. Tried to pick it up the middle. He had nowhere to go, tackled for a loss.
And you know how we talk about double A-gap pressure, meaning linebackers going in the gap between the center and the guard on either side? Well, it's not always to get to the passer. Sometimes you do that to prevent a running play. Worked pretty well in that situation.
The 41-yard punt, 9 on the return. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Four down. Check.
Now let's go.
There, jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Everything about that play kind of tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
Second down here after the incomplete pass.
Got it. Look. Hey, four down. Four down.
Set. Blue landing.
50's the mic. 50's the mic.
Second and 10. It's Lynch again. Left side here to Sanders. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
All right, here we go.
Throwing here, Lynch on first down. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
I like the boldness, and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered. He's able to get a hand in and knock it away.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. In the backfield is Anderson. Possible run in anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. And they'll give it to him here. Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to third and three now.
But this play sequence was really kind of called in reverse. Incomplete pass on first and 10. Nice run on second and 10 when probably everyone was expecting him to throw the football. Now, if you're the defense, what are they going to do on third down? You're a little off balance.
Three yards left to grab here on third down. Looking deep downfield, and he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Thomas, the intended target, and it's fourth and three.
Well, they decide to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
Big problems getting the play out, obviously. This will be a delay. Here's Riley Dixon now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. Deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And oh my, mistake there. Backs up, takes a fair catch at the 3 yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer. Create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and give these guys. Low man wins.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Caught out left side by Robinson. And able to get it across the 10 to the 15. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Fresh set of downs here. Here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. The All-Pro Von Miller there on the tackle. Well, a well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. Second down, here's Bortles. Completes it to Lee. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. 15 yards there on the catch and run.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the two-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the two-minute signal.
So applause here for us as well. Time to pay some bills. Back with more from Jacksonville. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back after this. For the offense lining up first and 10. Take this one up to the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 5, and that'll make this a second down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it, because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy with the right foot in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
They lost 2 there, and it's third down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side before loss yarded.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for loss yardage.
Here we go. Green 90. Green 90.
Throwing his Bortles on third down. And a dump off here to Robinson. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Ready.
Throwing on first down is Bortles. This is Yeldon on the dump off. Yeldon fighting. He wants the football. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. The Broncos offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over. Right? You're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
So the offense avoids disaster, keeps possession. Now it's second down. Bortles throwing on second down. Now he's hit, and Bortles fumbled. It's loose. A call it luck or skill, whatever. Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Nearly lost the football, but kept it after the fumble, but now they face a third down.
Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
Punt. This is a good kick as well. This is taken at the 18. Jags going to signal for another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Sanders, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
All right, here we go.
Second and 10, it's Lynch again. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Tashawn Gibson. And a potential turning point as they'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half. The Jags offense now gets set and heads back onto the field. And where the ball is now, you got the field goal pretty much in the bag. Now do you try for the end zone a couple of times?
I don't think there's any question about it. You might get a gift of 6 points rather than the three that you just noted that you feel like you already have. Be aggressive, go after it, and try and get those points.
So after the INT, it's Bortles. His throw caught at about the five. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And we'll get this one to go. It's good. So we reach halftime. And pump the brakes, Larry. Pump the brakes. We are ready for quarter number three. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. J.J. Nelson now to return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Out come the Jaguars now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. On first down, Bortles. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
And on second and 10 now. Bortles will try again on second down. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Throwing his Bortles on third down. He finds Hurns left side. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Here's Brad Nordman now as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. Play clock winding down. And taken right on the 30. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. So now a look at the Broncos as they head back out there for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively, and now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like in the half? Because that's exactly what they turned it up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Ledge, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Second down following the incompletion.
Here we go. Green 39.
Second and 10 now. It's Lynch. And this one is incomplete. He was trying to get it to Benny Fowler that time. And it's third down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. Thomas, the lone receiver, left.
Let's go! 3-19!
On third down, Lynch. And he will have a man, Demaryius Thomas. And that one good for 16 yards and a first.
The advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
Here we go now.
On first and 10, it's Lynch. And nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off the drive. He had a chance there to finish things off, didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down.
Let's go down.
Second and 10, it's Lynch again. Screen play, Anderson. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Wrench on first down, and that's incomplete.
The defensive coordinator came into this game with a plan to get to the quarterback with whatever type of pressure is necessary. It's working to perfection for him today.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Again on second and 10, it's Lynch. That is caught inside the 5.
Good job.
And he he's brought down. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
The lone receiver left. Here's Lynch being chased out left. And he's going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line.
On any first and goal, the real estate to work with for the offense is really cut down, and the defense knows it. So they often bring heat and pressure, which they did on this play. Got him down for a loss. Not a big one, but any loss of yardage in this position is tough for an offense.
Looks like the defense can press coverage here. On second down, Anderson. And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. C.J. Anderson, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Broncos cut into that lead. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
Yeah, that was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. And they'll get set here looking for the two-point conversion.
Four down.
Lynch going to try and throw for it. And now the pressure gets there, and he goes down. So he couldn't get rid of the football, and that deficit stays right where it is. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. Here comes the Jaguars offense as they get set here. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Throwing on first down is Bortles. Caught out left side by Robinson. Really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves his sticks.
So how do you beat man coverage? First of all, you want to be a superior receiver, but you know something, that guy is covering you, he's usually pretty good too. So the corner route is usually a great spot to get it done.
Instead, he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and no more. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is, and really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Throwing now is Bortles. Over the middle, the connection to Hearns. It's a gain of 7, and they're going to face a third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Still in search of the first down after that last completion. So they brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on 3rd and 3.
A good call.
To throw, it's Bortles. He's got the hookup to Lee. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even add a little extra at the end with a short run.
Black 58 rail! Black 58 rail!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's brought down. A nice carry there
quarterback controls just about everything on offense, but a lot of times what gets missed is that the center controls line play. He has to communicate to the guards and the tackles what type of front they're facing, how they're going to block it, and what adjustments need to be made sometimes on the fly as a defense will shift. Give the center a lot of credit because, for the most part, he's got big defensive linemen over his face all game long that he's got to try and block and protect his quarterback and create space for him.
Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Progressions. Not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
3 yards to go on second down.
Double tight.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Tighten up.
And Bortles throwing on second down. It's caught right side. It's Hurts. And we'll get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Allen Hurns, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Jaguars add on to their lead. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Now this Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll make it a second down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. Get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of there where all the big boys are, you know, make someone miss in the open field.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
Watch right.
And on 3rd and 3, they decided to go with a dime package. Six DBs.
Yeah, you're right. They've got 6 out there. And Fowler's got it. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Thomas, the lone receiver, left.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19.
On 1st and 10, it's Lynch. He's got time. He'll let this thing go for Sanders. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
2nd down now after the incompletion. They'll put 2 receivers left, 2 to the right. 2nd and 10 now. It's Lynch. Over the middle this time to Fowler. 12 yards there as they move the chains. So the offense has it first and 10.
Previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front.
Trip.
Nowhere to go with the football.
Got three.
Down he goes.
In the backfield is Anderson.
Right, here we go. Boom, landed.
On second down, here's Lynch. Blitz coming, and down he goes. The corner blitz gets there as he goes down for a loss of 7.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. A well-designed corner blitz that gets him for a loss of 8 yards. Third and long, defense with no fear, they brought the pressure.
Zero fear at all. That means they feel really good about the guys we're going to cover. But the biggest one is they think their pressure will get there before he has a chance to find an open receiver.
Fair catch called. It's taken in right at the 20-yard line. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
That was a really nice play. Be able to stack that one up. When they get back in the huddle, he's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They kept people off of him, allowed him to run free, and make the hit on the runner. He
filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a 1-yard gain.
Here we go. Green, 90.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Yeldon. And he'll be taken down after a minimal pickup, and that will take us to the end of quarter number 3. Back now in Jacksonville. It's Jaguar football here, and they'll look to extend their lead as we begin quarter number 4. And this defense looks for one more stop here on 3rd after the run. Give him 6 on the play, and that'll bring up 4th down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. And Denver getting set to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So here we go, 1st and 10
single,
now.
Single. You just watch 88 over there. Just watch
88.
From midfield now, here's Lynch. He's going to lead this for his running back. It's complete. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
If you're a selfish player, and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage lost, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. That kind of looks like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them.
And the Jags get to him as down he goes.
Are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down.
Here we go now.
Here we go. Lynch on fourth down. And Fowler's got it. 27 yards on the game there. And on fourth and long, somehow they're able to keep the drive going.
So the awareness of knowing where the first down marker is, it's not just for the offense. I mean, his defense has to understand that, too, and they gave up a huge one there.
Oh, yeah, this is one of those situations defensively. You're just counting on getting the football back.
No doubt about it. You've already projected yourself to the bench and a little bit of smile on your face for having stopped him, and now you've got to regroup and play again.
Thomas, the lone receiver, left. Second and 10, it's Lynch again. Oh, look at Thomas, wide open. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
He's come a long way since his time at Georgia Tech. What did he run at Tech? He ran hitches and go routes, essentially.
Yeah.
I mean, but he ran them really well. He averaged well over 20 yards a catch while he was there. And he still creates downfield in the NFL. That big body and that willingness to go catch the football. He's pretty impressive.
And his friends call him Bayway, a nickname his uncle gave him back in the day. They run, Anderson. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken him down on this drive before he finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Demaryius Thomas with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Broncos get a bit closer. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route. Ordinarily, it's probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Ready, green, no, go, go!
Check. Throwing on first down is Bortles. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet inbounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
So second and medium, second and 5 now.
Hey, we got 3. We got 3.
Now Bortles throwing on second down. And this one's incomplete. The offense offense in that middle ground here on third down, third and five.
Three down. Here we go. Green 90.
From the gun on third down, Bortles. And Robinson with a big catch. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they got to find a way to create a turnover or take away. Otherwise, this will probably get away from them.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Give them a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Second down. Black
58 rail. Black 58. Close.
Hey, watch it. Watch it.
Green. Blue.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
So it'll be first down here after the run.
Quiet, team, we're pretty quiet.
Left, check, left. Here we go. Blue, 45.
They keep it with Yeldon on first down. And he'll take this one up. Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now they'll throw it. Bortles. He's got time in the pocket. And he is going to be hit and taken down. Bortles sacked. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down.
Four down. Here we go now.
Third and long, it's Bortles. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. Here's Brad Nordman now as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. And a nice special teams job here. This is going to be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time.
Here we go.
What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. Okay, so now the question, how did he get that wide open?
Well, we both know that he shouldn't, because from the time they handed out scouting reports before this game, he was circled, starred, everything. Find him, cover him. But sometimes you can scheme a guy open. You put the receivers in a bunch. Maybe you move some motion. Maybe you put him on the backside of a formation, and all of a sudden you've got a better matchup. Every now and then, the offensive guys, hopefully you're ready to get him open, even with everyone keeping eyes on him.
And that's certainly a guy they want to keep trying to scheme open. Left side here to Sanders. They get 25 yards out of that one, and it'll give the Broncos a first down. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's. And that's exactly what they did there.
On first First down, it's Lynch to the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Second down now after the pass completion. Thomas, the lone receiver left.
All right, here we go.
From midfield now, here's Lynch. The complete into the hands of Fowler. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Caught with a gain of 5. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
Hurry up, here we go. No. Check. Patriot. Patriot. All right, here we go.
They'll run it. Here's Anderson. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and 2 is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
They'll throw on first down with Lynch. Sanders has it over the middle. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Call it a 3-yard gain, and it'll bring up a second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Lynch looking to throw on second. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is third and 7.
All right, here we go. Green, 39. Green, 39.
On third down, Lynch. C.J. Anderson, the intended target, and it's fourth down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
So on now is Brandon McManus. He has hit from as far away as 57, but that was in Denver. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. And this is going to wind up left. Well struck, but it's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given away just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, sent this one off target.
Bortles going to give the Yeldon. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. And now the Broncos will burn another timeout here. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the 2-minute warning, and we'll be back. Right. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Take this one up close to about the 45. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter.
And the Broncos go to a nickel set on third down.
Yeah, they've got extra DB out there. Throwing his balls. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. DeMarcus Ware with a big time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of 7.
Good job, good job.
Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. Here's Brad Nordman now as they're forced to kick for the 6th time today. Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the 5, all the way down at the 2-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try running for in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Set! Green, 39! Green, 39!
Now it's Lynch. And Sanders has got it complete. And he's out of bounds, able to get it up right near the 25 to the 24.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to grade the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you?
And his throw here is incomplete.
And that one was knocked away, and I think the defender's going to be a little upset with themselves. They made the play on the football, but that one felt like a forced pass by the quarterback. Thought he had somewhat open. He really wasn't. Maybe an example of having too much confidence in his receiver that no matter what, I'm going to throw it to him. And that was a play made by the defense, and it could have been a bigger one.
Nowhere to escape when he goes down. A man who missed his entire rookie season, Dante Fowler. In there to take him down, and the clock will roll.
All right, now, look at 56. Here we go now. Hey, now, Barney, Barney.
Here's Lynch. Now, Fowler's got it. And he's eventually brought down, but not before he reaches the 39, just shy of the 40. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that first down pass.
Throwing now is Lynch. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by Tashawn Gibson. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. Out comes the Jaguar offense now as they get set to take over. They're in a good spot. Two-possession game barely, but a two-possession game here late. Now they just have to put this game on ice.
Let's face it, right now, they're talking about ball security, taking care of it, not allowing anything crazy to happen, because we've seen nutty things happen down the stretch, but they also have the security of the scoreboard. With that type of a lead, even if something goes haywire, they're still in good shape.
We got three. Three down, three down. Here we go. Green, 90.
Bortles with a knee to the ground, and that should do it. Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Jaguars are winners here as we say so long from Jacksonville.